Hello, I'm David and today I'm going to test the LED headlight bulbs from Aliexpress. I bought three different models and I will compare them to the standard H4 bulb. The first pair costs $17, second $35 and third $19. Here you can see how all of them look. I chose models with passive cooling only, because those with active cooling are more fragile in my opinion. Here you can see how the LED chip looks like in each bulb. Here are differences in length compared to standard H4 bulb. You can notice that this one with cooling strips is the shortest one. The others have similar length. Changing standard bulb is easy. You just insert the bulb into socket and lock it. Then you install the dust cover. Changing LED is a bit different. First, you demount the plastic socket and install it in the headlight socket. Next, you lock it in place and put in the dust cover. The last step is bulb mounting. Now, let's measure power consumption for each bulb. I will use battery as power source. Here you can see the bulb pinout. Ground connection is the leftmost flat connector. The upper connector is low beam and at the right is the high beam connector. To measure power, we need to measure voltage and current for the low and high beam. As you can see, the LED bulbs in general consume much less power. Next, I try to check light distribution for low and high beam. First, I switch on the low beam and try to notice cutoff line from the short distance. Second, I switch on the high beam and check if the light distribution is proper. Unfortunately, the camera had some problems to record this in decent quality, so I prepared another test, at night and from bigger distance. This time cutoff line is much more visible. You can notice that two bulbs at the bottom got perfect low beam cutoff line. Two upper bulbs make two light spots above the cutoff line. Spots like this can be dangerous because they can blind other drivers on the road. High beam looks similar in all cases, but anyway it's less important. We don't use them when we see other drivers. I also made photos of low and high beam for each bulb using the same camera settings. At the end, I used this headlight as a flashlight for better comparison how each bulb lights the area around. Personally, I like this one because it got perfect cutoff line and also it is most energy saving. Which one do you think is the best? Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed, leave a like and subscribe.